Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. Here it is, World 10, Ultra Heaven. By the way, I forgot to mention in the last part, World 9 has my favorite music in the game. I have no idea how I forgot to mention that, considering that, you know, I pretty much live off of game music. If you didn't realize that from my Kirby walkthrough, but yeah. Well, okay, I don't live off it, but anyway, let's start it. This place has also got pretty awesome music as well. Definitely worth unlocking just to play the stages and music alone. If you can unlock it. As I said, Sinking Swamp, very, very hard to get a gold crown on. So, do your best. This one reminds me of the Eight Rings one. I think it's called Eight Rings in... Somehow I lived! It reminds me of that Eight Rings one in Super Monkey Ball 2, where you have to use the slope's momentum to your advantage. Same concept, basically. You just gotta angle yourself towards wherever the next platform is. You can tell where it's going just by looking at it as you're at the bottom of each slope. On this one, not that hard of a stage either. The main gimmick of the stage, if you will, is this treadmill here, even though I'm somehow having trouble getting on top of this treadmill. This isn't even a treadmill, it's just like got these slidey things, and you could actually just roll right over them, but I just prefer to jump over them. And that's pretty much it for the stage. You just got the end here, and yeah, it's definitely a lot easier than you would expect for World 10, but believe me, the stages, starting with this one, get evil. Now, you could just go through the whole rigmarole of doing the whole pathway on this one. Like here, I'll just show you for this first run. You go just around like this, and you go down the slope, control your speed, and you go left, left again, diagonal down these platforms. You probably want to jump towards them so that you'll have more control, like that, and then whoa! And then when you get to here, you've got this checkerboard pattern you'll see right here. And now what you need to have is a lot of speed, and so the problem with that is it's very hard to get speed at that particular angle. So how I like to do this stage is something like this. It's kind of luck based, but come on, let's face it, the normal path is luck based, probably even more so. That's how I like to do this stage, is just to jump at those checkerboard areas right there and try to land on flat spots and jump towards the goal. Hopefully. That's the very best possible way that I've been able to find a way to beat this stage. Oh, I nicked the corner! Oh, must aim for flat spot. And no, those are completely flat, despite those red squares being on the edges, like you see there. They just indicate where there is an edge, like where you can fall off easily, or where there's a jump or something like that. But otherwise, those platforms are perfectly flat. You just have to aim for the flat spot and not an edge. Because when you're going at such high speed and you're aiming at, you know, something that's angled, you're just gonna bounce right off the stage. Give it another try. I don't think I will ever have the skill needed to beat Ultra Heaven without a continue. This is by far the hardest Monkey Ball challenge ever. It's only 9 stages, but oh my. Well, 9 stages and a bonus stage. Yeah, there's another bonus one. Blah. Good. Yeah! That's how it's done, baby. Replays for the win. Oh, she's so cute. And, oh, it's cylinders all over again. Why do you do this to me? Why? For this, you want to wait for that blue one to go all the way to the right, and then make your run towards the green one. You'll see as I go why I want to do that. Because, see, the way that you want to land up is on that left platform, and you want the blue one to be there when you get there, basically. And these cylinders are so huge, it's so hard to tell where the center of them are. Like, as you're jumping towards the next one, unless you have like a full-on view, So it's very, very hard to control your landings if you can't tell exactly where you are. Like, wherever you're hitting the cylinders. Okay, we're good, I think. Do not hit those. Do not, and I mean do not hit those. Because they land up to that bumper, which will kill you. Oh, and there's the goal spinning on the very last one. This yellow one's quite fast. Aim for the bananas. They indicate the center of the cylinder. Get it, get it, get it, freaking! I can't believe I got it! So stressful. But not as stressful as the next stage. Not the bonus stage. For this one, you just want to land onto a ring and stay there to collect bananas. And that's pretty much it. They rotate, but you don't even feel the rotation as you're going around them, if you go around them properly. Just don't be on one of those sticks between these things as it's rotating, otherwise, well, you're gonna fall off, but I fell out anyway. But who cares about bonus stages anyway? This one. Let's do that one later. Let's go over to number 6. For this one, you want to try and get onto the clock minute hand, or maybe it's a second hand. I'm kind of unsure here, but it's definitely a clock. I think it's a second hand, but it goes pretty dang fast for a second hand. Go see that? It's coming around here. Now get hit by it. Now, don't fall off. I was going to say get hit by it and try to stay on it. What you want it to do is push you at the same speed it's going, and then get a little ahead of it in speed and try to jump inside it. You'll see why. That thing leads to the goal, but the easiest way to do it is to get on the same speed as it's going. Alright, so this time I'm going to have it tap me like so! How I ended up on the inside of that, you know, not getting knocked to the outside, I have no idea. Come on, this one isn't that hard. This is one of the easiest ones in World 10. Come on, PkGam, have some focus here. Maybe I shouldn't be rushing through those things, because this stage isn't that long as a whole. I don't even know why I'm bothering to rush. Well, I guess I do have to get over here to that thing. Okay, now touch me, okay? Okay, this is what you want, something like this. Now get ahead of it ever so slightly, and try to jump inside it, like that. Now, carefully work your way over towards the center. You won't have a railing at a certain point, which is right here. But that's okay, it's very easy to control yourself, as long as you go slow. Carefully. If you see yourself going towards the front, slow down. If you see yourself going towards the back, speed up. And you won't have any trouble getting towards the center. Come on. You can do it, Yan Yan. I believe in you. And you'll notice that you get slower and slower as you get to the center, which actually throws you off, so be ready to adjust for that as you go. Well, not be ready to adjust for it. You're going to have to adjust for it. And it goes gradually. And there you go. Woo! Next stage is... Oh, this one. This one is quite dealio. It's not this initial section. The thing that gives me the most trouble, by far, is getting into the goal. And you're going to see why that is once I get there. Getting onto that moving thing is not all that hard, believe it or not. You just got to aim towards the right as it's coming towards you. And then jump towards it ever so slightly, and then jump to control your speed. Like that. Now, jump all the way over here, and you can skip most of the stage. Now watch this. Platforms magically appear out of nowhere! Do not question the game logic, people. And man, this is probably by far my most non-kid-friendly game yet. The monkeys, most of them don't wear pants. There's ladies with huge bosoms. You're committing all sorts of violence against the bosses in the game. It is just horrible altogether. Now, if, in case you don't notice, you're going to have to jump for the goal, and you're going to have to do it ever so slightly blindly. Oh, I can't believe I got it on my first try! I am so proud of myself that the timing of that is so tight, especially since, you know, you can't see what you're doing. This is one of my favorite stages in the game, actually, because you're literally jumping through hoops across the abyss, and if you hit an edge of the hoop, you're pretty much done for. So this is a precise jumping stage. These first two just give you a little intro as to how the stage is like, but it gets a lot more precise as you go. This is all skill-based, and I like that! This is my kind of stage, baby. Now you jump through here, and yes, this thing is swinging, so you gotta carefully jump across as it's swinging. Yeah. There's a little lip there, so you gotta have enough speed to get across it. This thing is hanging above the abyss. This one, now you gotta use the boosters to get through. Oh yeah! And of course, they use the goal ring as the last ring you jump through, which is pretty clever as well. Woo! And number 9. I got through this world a lot faster than I thought I would, honestly. Except for it. You know exactly what I'm talking about. That stage. Anyway, try and control your speed as you're going up here, because you're gonna fly off regardless of those little sloped corners there. Oh, just like that. So slow down using your jumps if at all possible as you're going up the slopes. You don't have much time to get to the top, so you're gonna have to go fairly fast to get up there. But you don't have to go too fast, you just have to be fast enough. But once you get past this section, then you got probably the hardest section in the stage, where you got a one square wide platform that you have to roll across. Oh my. This right here. And it's sloped ever so slightly from the outside to the inside, so you gotta keep your speed up as you're going across it. Now you've got more of these, but these aren't quite... Well, they're just as hard as the other ones, I should say. It's just the thing of it, you can't lose control and avoid touching the arrows in general. That was a pretty good run. I have faith that I'm gonna be able to beat the stage quickly. Maybe. I've said a lot of maybes during this walkthrough because, well, Monkey Ball is a hard video game series, in case you didn't realize that. If you can't tell that from the recording, you will once you play this game for yourself. If you ever play this game for yourself, or if you've ever played a game in the series. Other than the mobile versions, I hear the mobile versions are pretty easy. I am doomed! See, that's why you have to keep your speed up on that thin platform. If you have the right speed, it's not that hard to get through it. It reminds me a lot of that one in World 7, the lava one, where you have to go down the slope on a thin platform while it's angled, like, similar to that. It's a very similar concept, except it's because you have to control your speed. One you have to slow down on this one you have to speed up to keep your speed on it, and you have to keep that speed steady. Okay, steady, steady. See, it's not too difficult. Except I lost my composure near the end. You'll notice that it straightens out near the end as well of that thin slope. That's another thing that might throw you off, because you have to recompensate for your speed, because you're going at a certain speed to make it up, make it through that sloped curve. But the issue is that once you get to the straighter section, you have to slow back down, and that's very hard to get the feel on. Oh, I panicked by jumping. I had it too, because you'll notice that I was starting to caress myself over to the edge, to the other edge again, but I panicked and jumped anyway, and that's where I lost it. I think I can use the slopes to get up there a little bit, use the arrows to get up there a little faster in most cases, except this one. That one seems a little risky. That's the one that I flew off of. Come on, Yan Yan, we can do this. Speed is good, very good. There, that's exactly how you want to do it. Pay attention to the mile per hour speed there, if you didn't realize that. No! You know, at the bottom left corner there. Is that slightly sloped there? Man, I hope not. No! Oh, I don't want to hurry up. I want to live. No! so well. This song is a lot more stressful than I remember. This is a fun stage though, I gotta admit. It's all about the control, all about the speed control. That was just heartbreaking. Oh. But I have faith that I can do it, no matter how many tries it takes, no matter how many fails, I will do it. Whoa, okay, I got that down. I got that down. I'm getting a little loony, but I've got it down. Do not hit Arrow of Doom. So much precision. Such a little area. No! Freak! Right there! I was right there! I don't have enough time to make it up to the top again. Even though I'm safely down here. But, oh, that was two good runs in a row. My hands are tingling. I have a feeling that's a bad sign. My health is deteriorating because of this stage. But I will make it for you. Before I have to get rushed to emergency room or something. Oh, wow. No. I can't be too slow. Ah, oh, I'm serious. My hands are literally tingling. So close. Yeah, I think the trick to that slope is just to use your speed to control yourself rather than jumping. Jumping across that slope is indeed possible, but speed control is definitely a lot easier to manage. I think I'm getting a little too impatient now to finish the stage. I'm purposely hitting the arrow panels. No, I refuse. No, okay. I think I can see why people like to see all the fails in the video, because there's a lot more tension for the viewer. There's a lot of tension for the player as well. I can assure you. Come on. Yes. Yes. Alright, hardest stage in the game right here. 10-5 of Ultra Heaven. See all those little colored squares? Those aren't just squares, they are little pyramids. And depending on the color, depends on the intensity. Yellow is like medium, orangish red is the highest, and of course the bluish green is the weakest. Now, the issue of this stage is that you have to jump across these things. And yes, you really actually do have to jump across them and try and control your speed. If I don't make it through this stage, if all else fails, I have replay data of me actually beating the stage, because the stage is, and probably forever will be, the hardest Super Monkey Ball stage in the game's history. Not only is it incredibly difficult to control yourself on the stage, but there is a glitched platform near the end that you can actually fall through. It looks exactly like the one I'm standing on right here. And you have to jump across it and then land on some arrow panels and try and control yourself while you're flying across the pyramids of doom. So, if I don't make it through this, I will show the stage's completion through the replay data. And in case you don't realize, I'm rushing through this stage, and there's a good reason behind this. This stage is also extremely long, and you've only got 60 seconds to do it. So you want to make as much time as you possibly can to get through this stage. And to be honest with you, I seriously don't feel like playing through this stage. I've only beat the stage 2 times in my entire life. Once just to get through the game, and the second time to get a replay off of it. I didn't even beat it as I was doing my practice run through Ultra Heaven. I just didn't feel like practicing it. Like, I just didn't want to put the time and effort to get through this stage. And yes, I know I could just roll across those first sections of pyramids easily, but as I said, I'm working on time management here. I need to save as much time as I can to get through this stage. And the trick to doing that is actually to hit those flat platforms, and that'll actually be more consistent than using the pyramids in the long run once you get the feel of it down. Or at least it is for me. That's how I remember the stage to be. But you can't use these flat platforms for long. You're going to be forced to... I keep overshooting that first jump. Calm down, PkGam. Just carefully get... Maybe I should just be using the pyramids. I just want to show as much of the stage as I possibly can. Like, on my own, to show you just how much pain it takes to get through this stage. If you don't understand the severity of the difficulty of the stage. Alright. Now I'm going to try and get across there and control! Oh! Nope! That ain't gonna work! See, the issue, as you can tell, is that you're landing on little pointed surfaces. And in case you can't tell, you know, by playing through this entire game, you are inside a ball, and balls do not interact well with the little pointed surfaces. They bounce all over the place. Just a little physics science for you there, in case you didn't realize that. And somehow I made it. And yes, there's still more. All right, carefully. Get yourself, yes, they get even smaller as you go. And, oh my god, nope, ain't gonna happen. I didn't think it was gonna work. This stage is pretty much 100% luck-based. Okay, it's like 95% luck-based. Especially since of that glitch platform. You aren't gonna know about that glitch platform near the end unless you actually hit the glitch platform and fall right through it. Somehow, I actually bounced backwards there and that threw me off. I was actually aiming to hit, like, off that stone pillar there as like a basketball backboard shot, because I noticed how fast I was going, but alas, the unpredictable little pyramids here threw me off my timing because it made me go backwards instead of forward, and that's the issue of this stage. And it's because of how the stage is designed, I would go so far as to say that it is the worst monkey ball stage in the series' history. And that's why I don't want to play through this stage at all. And that's why I didn't practice it at all. It's, oh, this stage is just preposterous. It is the bane of my existence. It is the bane of every Super Monkey Ball player's existence. There's just no consistency to this stage. Well, okay, there's consistency. It is going to consistently knock you off time and time again, over and over and over. Oh, I even almost fell off there, because the little pyramids almost knocked me off with a little... the amount of speed that I had there. Oh, no, no, I can't fall off there. No, not yet. I have to get some way far into the stage. I would be very, very surprised if I could actually beat the stage on camera without showing the replay. I wonder how long I should keep trying at this stage before giving up on it. Like, should I go the full force and actually attempt to beat the stage for the third time in my life? Or should I just go for the replay? I don't know, but I'm probably gonna, like, eventually add, or I should say I'm probably already added something that'll be like, click this to skip over to the winning run or something like that. Providing that I actually manage a winning run. But this stage is just so discouraging in the way that it's designed, because you have just such a small chance of getting through it. It's unbelievably difficult. And as you see, every time I do that section with those jumps, it ends up being different each and every time, and I have to react to it different each and every time. And that's the power the stage holds upon the players, the unpredictable nature of it. because you just can't jump perfectly each and every time. It's just absolutely impossible to do that. And because I hit the little orangish reddish pyramid there, I ended up bouncing backwards and I didn't have enough forward momentum to get across to the other side. But you can get through this stage if you keep trying. I've said this before and I'll say it again. If you keep trying at something, you will eventually succeed, no matter what it is. I tried to skip the second one there because I had a lot of speed after hitting the first one. But alas, it wasn't enough speed to make it to the other side, and this stage is just such a killjoy. There's so many frustrated moments involving this stage and my past Super Monkey Ball history that it's just not fun to play for me. Not fun for me to play anymore. And I hit the little orange one. Wow. This is a piece of work. That's all I can say about it. I have no more commentary to say about this stage. Despite this being pyramid-based, not even the ancient Egyptians could approve of this stage. This is torture. It is worse than the rack. Worse than any torture you could possibly imagine. Nope. Thumb screws have nothing on this stage. The sheer amount of pain this stage brings upon players. Oh, did I actually make it somewhere this time again? Yes, I did. I can't believe it. And now I have to somehow make these jumps. Oh, am I gonna make it? Oh, the chances are not in my favor. Oh, I overjumped. What I was trying to do is hit the forward slope of the pyramids, and the most consistent way to do that is to hit the very edge of the platform, but it's just next to impossible to do that consistently. Nope, don't fall off there, Nyan Yan. Don't fall off there. And this stage is also practically impossible unless you're using Nyan Yan because of her high jump. But still, even with her, you can tell is practically unbeatable. I just wonder if I should just stop now and just show the replay of me actually beating the stage, and then maybe do a follow-up video of me beating the stage again later, because I really, really don't feel like playing the stage at this given moment. Oh, somehow I made it! Somehow I made it! The crowd goes wild! No, don't hit the center like that! You want to hit those little pyramids as directly as you possibly can, so that you get a more vertical jump rather than one that knocks you to the left or the right. If you get knocked to the left or the right, it's pretty much over. You're gonna lose control. Wow. How did I ever manage to beat the stage? Well, I guess we're gonna find out if I ever get to that replay. I think this is going to be my last set of lives before I actually go to the replay. And then maybe, just maybe, I'll play, do the stage one last time in my life and then put the stage down once and for all to never touch it again. Somehow I got lucky there. Maybe the speed is the key to get through this. I don't know. Alright. Angle yourself and the camera, but don't dilly-dally. Oh my goodness. No! That's the furthest I ever got. And just look how many tries it took me to get that far. Count them. And that's literally that much of a chance to get that far into the stage. And then it's still not over. It's luck-based from beginning to end. Well, maybe not the very beginning, but you know what I mean. Oh, I got hit and knocked off to the side. That means I'm not gonna survive. Yeah, this is gonna be the last life that I'm gonna be using here. And then I'm gonna go over to my replay data just to finish this. because nothing that I show you in these many, many retries here is gonna help you. It's sorry to say, but you are going to be tormented like no other Monkey Ball stage before if you play the stage and try to beat it. I'm sorry. Yeah, that's it. I'm done here.
Continue?
No, I'm going to my replay data. I've had enough torture. No one could possibly take much more. I think the replay data is in the options. Oh, yeah, I went too far, didn't I? Yeah. That's okay. Options. Watch and view your play record. Replay. Of course, there's only one thing that I have saved here, because it is truly an achievement if you get this thing beat. Alright. I'm putting down the controller and post-commentating this sucker. Yes, a winning run of Ultra Heaven 10-5. And, I guess apparently I didn't do those jumps on my winning run here. I did go through these. And I can tell that I was trying to rush through the stage regardless. And... wow. That just looks ridiculous, just watching it. Alright, now how the heck did I manage to pass this part and land on those orange pyramids on the other side? I went down... oh my! Oh, I skipped most of them, that's how I did it. Okay. That was probably another lucky run. Oh god, there's... holy crap! It's a 2-square-wide area. Now this platform right here, jump across it, it's glitched. Do not touch that platform. And that's how it's done. And now, if you tell me that stage isn't luck-based, you're crazy. Well, I hope you enjoyed this part, and I'll see you in the next part when I do the 50 Party Games of Death. Toodaloo!